Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my retractable corner water elevator with a direct and exclusive level selection. Now this build is based on a previous elevator design by me, which also already had a direct level selection, but it wasn't an exclusive level selection. So, well, let's show you this in action so you can see the actual difference. So how is the elevator built? We have basically on this corner here, our place where the elevator water tube will be deployed, and we have a button panel. Now, since in this example here I only have 6 floors, the button panel also only has 6 buttons. You can have up to 16 buttons for this design here. You can actually have more than just 16 floors, but then you will only have a subsection of floors you can select at each button panel. Anyway, let's show you this in action. So the current floor is marked with the wooden button here. So we are currently on floor number 3. And let's say I want to go to floor number 1. All I need is to press the button, wait a few moments until this thing here properly sets. And now I can jump in here. You can see I can't get out at level number 2. I can only get out at level number 1. So that's what I mean with a exclusive level selection. You can only get from the point where you start to the point where you want to end up. If I want to go, let's say, back, I just need to press the button number 3, wait a short moment, and then once the system has properly set, I can just jump in, and now I'm back to number 3. If I don't need elevator anymore, all I need to do is press the wooden button, and the system will automatically close again. So, very nice, and very easy to use, and the main difference to the previous version is just that you can't jump in or out at one of the other floors. So it's an exclusive point-to-point connection. And that's basically what this elevator does. Now let's talk about the sizes. Obviously, the height of the entire thing depends on the number of floors and the spacing of them. But the minimum distance between floors is 9 blocks, so the floor itself is basically 9 blocks high. Then let's talk about the length of it. So it's a total of 9 blocks long, and the width of it depends on your button panel. If you have a shorter button panel, obviously the width is a bit shorter, but if you had the maximum button panel, it would be 16 blocks wide. In my case here, I have removed 2 slices. And that's the sizes. Now let's talk about required resources. So for each of the floors, with the exception of the topmost floor, you're gonna need a couple building blocks, then a couple slabs, or 7 slabs to be more precise, 19 stairs, a magma block and a soul sand block. Then 77 redstone dust, 16 redstone torches, 28 redstone repeaters, 10 comparators, 22 observers, 1 redstone block, 5 normal pistons and 22 sticky pistons, 10 node blocks, 3 dispensers. For each dispenser you're gonna need an empty bucket, then 2 hoppers, 17 stone buttons and a wooden button, then a composter and something to put into the composter, at least 1 layer. Then, depending on the size of your button panel, a couple of signs. And obviously a lot of water to waterlog the various blocks and the water tubes. Additionally, if the distance between floors is greater than 9, you're gonna need to extend the connections. This is for one the water tube, and for the other, it's those 4 signal lines here plus the torch tower here, which equates to 4 observers, node blocks and normal blocks for every 3 blocks in between, and 2 torches and 2 blocks for every 4 blocks in between. And finally, the topmost module is quite a bit cheaper, so here you're gonna need, besides some building blocks, 2 slabs, 3 stairs, 38 redstone dust, 5 redstone torches, 5 repeaters, 8 comparators, 6 observers, 4 sticky pistons, 3 node blocks, 2 hoppers, 16 buttons, and 1 wooden button. At least this is a rough estimation. And that should be enough of a prologue, so let's get straight to building this elevator here. Okay, so the first step is figuring out where you want your floors to be. When doing so, make sure that the distance between floors is at least 9 blocks. It can be greater, like here, but it can't be smaller or the circuitry will not fit. Next, it's time to place a few blocks so you get the general layout correctly. The starting point for that is this block here, which is at the floor level and at the point where we have the corner of our future room where the water column will be. Towards the back, we need a magma block. Towards the left, a soil sand block. Put next to those two, then normal blocks. In those two cardinal directions, we need stairs, which later on will be waterlogged and keep water from spilling out. And then we, for now, just need this rest of the 3x3 floor here. Towards the left, we have the beginning of our first wall, of the left wall. And towards the right, the wall with the button panel starts at this point here. I will come to the button panel in a few moments, but for now, let's actually go down. The next layer down is just normal blocks, with the exception of the block towards the right, so towards the button panel. This should be a stairs block, which can be placed this way, or also the other way around. Doesn't really matter, but I think this looks a bit nicer from the outside. This later on will be the place where you can actually look through and press the button if you get accidentally stuck in the elevator. Following that, we need a 3-high part of the water tube. You can use glass blocks here to make it a bit more visible, but it's completely optional. So that's the general setup of that, and with that we come to the button panel itself. What you can see here is the maximum button panel with 16 buttons. The lowest button value is the one in this corner here, and then it goes clockwise around from 1 up to 8. Then down here we begin with the 9 over there and go over to the 16 in this corner. So a button panel the length of 8. As you can see, if you go from this 3x3 floor here, we have first one essentially gap before we start with the actual button panel. Now, when building this button panel, you should be aware of how many floors you want to build. This is the reason also why I mentioned before that you should figure out what setup you want to go with. If you have more than 16 floors, you can have a subgroup of the 16 floors that's elected here. For example, you go from 3 up to 18, for example. If you have less, then you can obviously reduce the number of buttons. Now you can do this in two ways. The first is just starting by removing buttons. Make sure you don't remove buttons from the middle here, because you need one continuous setup for this thing to work. You can start at the ends. Either one will do. Or if you remove from the side, make sure you remove the entire slice. So what do I mean with that? First, let's quickly place them. So let's say we have just 15 floors, then I would recommend removing this button over there. If you have 14 floors, I would recommend actually removing this entire slice. And so on. You can do this with up to two complete slices. Due to the way the circuitry behind this will work later on, you can't make this shorter than 6 wide as a button panel if you have two rows of buttons. This means from this point on, you will have to remove either symmetrical or just remove the buttons. Now, since in this elevator here, I will only have 6 floors in total, I only need this bottom row here. Then let's quickly go and correct those signs here. So this is the highest level floor, 6. Then here we have the 4, sorry, the 5, then the 4, then the 3, then the 2, and finally the 1. And then the last step is marking the current floor with a wooden button. And as you can see, I've already done that for the other 5 floors. And that's about that part done. Now, the topmost and the bottommost floor are slightly different. For the topmost floor, you won't need any magma or soil sand here. And if we go down here, You will see that we don't need the water tube at the lowest point. Here we just need the gap where the soil sand or magma block will be pushed in. Below that you can simply close up the tube. And that's our starting point. And with that, let's continue on building the circuitry behind the button panels. Now for the circuitry of the button panel, we start below this bottom row with a row of normal blocks for the total width of our panels. As you can see, since my button panel is only 6 blocks wide, I also only need 6 blocks here. If it was wider, I would need 7 or 8 blocks. Replace the second block with a hopper, then put redstone dust on top. Then go behind the entire thing, and if you had a second or a top row of buttons, you would have to start with an upside down step at this first position here, if it is used. So if I had a button here, then continue on with a row of normal blocks all the way over here, once more redstone dust on top of those blocks. Then we need 2 blocks diagonally like this here, redstone dust up here and the comparator in here. And now we would have basically connected both button rows into a single line at the back. Since we only have 6 buttons in this example, I don't need to place this in here, but if you have more buttons, you would have to do so. Anyway, let's continue on. Now, let's go 3 blocks over from the hopper, and at the back we need a block here. Then 2 raised blocks in the direction of the hopper, and 1 more raised block there. Put down 3 redstone dust, and a torch there. Then put another block here and a raised block, redstone dust here, torch there, sticky piston on top, observer in this direction, running into a full block with a lowered block in here, then redstone dust on top. Then let's go back down here. First we need a block here and diagonally another block. Put a comparator here, taking output from the hopper, and another one here to take an output from this redstone wire. Put 2 blocks down here, some redstone wire there, another comparator there, which you put in the subtract mode. Then put a 2x2 of normal blocks here, a lowered block here, and a raised block there. Put redstone dust on top of those 3 blocks, cut off the wire here with a full block. Then place down 2 comparators like this here, the torch on this side of the block. Then a sticky piston with an observer in this direction, running into a full block. Then let's go to this corner here again. First place a block in front of the comparator, put some redstone dust on top. Then another block here with a comparator in a subtract mode on top. Right behind the comparator we need a node block with a hopper following that. Then in front of the comparator we need a block here, to the side of that an upside down step. Then 2 blocks like this. Then a raised block here and a lowered block there. Put 2 redstone wire here and here. A comparator running into this block and one in the opposite direction. Then 1 block in front of this wire there. Following that around this corner 2 blocks like this here. A repeater on 4 ticks and one on 2 ticks there. Run this directly into a sticky piston and then an observer which would power a full block on top of this node block here. And that's more or less the circuitry of the button panel itself done. This needs to be replicated on all floors, but what needs to be done yet is we need to program it so it knows what floor we are currently on. And that is done by adjusting the amount of items in this hopper and this hopper here. The number of items can be determined rather easily. For that, check what the signal strength at this point here would be. So in this case it would be 12. And now what you need to do is you need to have a signal strength coming out of this hopper, if you take a comparator, that is equal to that. So if you have the F3 menu, you can just do it with this little setup like this here, and then just start adding until you have the correct signal strength. So in this case, as you can see, I have 12 here, and I have 12 here. So, in other words, I need to fill in 4 stacks of items. And obviously, I need to do the same here. So, let's quickly do this, and that's the circuitry more or less primed correctly. So, then it's time to replace the button again. And now I need to quickly do this for the other floors. And voila. So now, as you can see, I've added the button panel circuitry for all floors and also already adjusted the amount of items in the hoppers correctly. Now, technically speaking, you could remove part of the circuitry at the bottommost and topmost modules to make this a bit cheaper, since you only need to go in one direction and the circuitry is set up to control the circuitry in both directions. But technically speaking, it's not that much saved in terms of resources. For the bottommost module, you could leave out this part here leading to this piston here. And for the bottommost module, you could actually leave out this part at the bottom here leading to this piston here. But as you can see, it's not that many resources that would be saved in the overall design. But anyway, now it's time to start building the more mechanical components of the elevator. Okay, so the next few steps don't apply to the topmost station, so you won't have to build the entire and slightly complex elevator cabin for that. Anyway, let's continue on this intermediate floor here. We go right behind this corner here, and two down from the magma and the soul sand block, we need a block here. Put some redstone dust on top. Then a block to this side here with a repeater on one tick, running into a full block with a torch on the side of it, like so. Put a block on top, torch on top, block on top, block to this side, and a raised block here. Put redstone dust on top of those two blocks, and a repeater on two ticks in there. Then let's go to the other side, and here we do pretty much the same. So a block here, repeater running into a full block, torch there, block on top, torch on top, block here, next to the torch, and one diagonal there. Redstone dust on top, and a repeater on two ticks in there. Then let's go and add 3 double pistons extenders here, and the same on this side. So, come on, like so, and one down here. And as you can see, there should be at the same height as the wall of our cabin. Then let's go into the corner again, and here we need to place a block diagonally to the block below the magma block. Put a repeater on one tick in this direction, then a block diagonally here with another repeater on one tick. In this space here, later on will be a connection to the next lower floor, but we will come to that at a later point. Then place a block in front of this repeater, put some redstone dust on top. Then we need a row of 3 blocks here with some redstone dust. A block here to cut off that wire. Then we need a block diagonally here, so we can place a torch which should power this redstone line there. Next, place a block down here with a comparator running into this block. On this side here, first we need a block there, then a block down here, repeater on one tick running into this direction, running into a full block. With a torch to this side, block on top, and a torch to this side. Then, first go up and down like this here. Then we need to make this a checker pattern to wide as this here. Put a repeater on two ticks in there, redstone dust here and here, and a torch right there. And with that, it's time to start placing two pistons. The first sticky piston goes on top of the torch here and runs into the soul sand there. And the next goes in front of the torch here and at the moment should be powered. Now, if you want, you can get yourself a lever and test if everything works properly. So if we power this one here, this here should swap out to the soul sand. If we depower it, it should also go in this direction. Now, let's place a block temporary here and click the lever on, and now we should have this opening here being open completely and also those parts here closing. And that should be independent of whether we change this, obviously. Then let's quickly see if this also works with the source end, and that's what you want to see. So that's exactly how it should behave. Now let's remove our levers again. And let's continue on with the circuitry. Go into the corner again, and here we start with an observer looking at this one tick repeater over there. Put two blocks to the front of it, so some wire here and a repeater on four ticks in this direction. Then place two blocks down here, redstone wire there, and a repeater on two ticks in this direction. Place two raised blocks like so, then go up a layer, down a layer, put a block here, a repeater on three ticks on top, then put redstone dust on this line here, and some redstone dust up there on top of this block in front of the repeater. Then let's go and add another block here and here, and on top of this redstone dot there, make sure this stays in a cross shape and is not accidentally put into a dot shape. Then an upside down slab here, followed by a row of three blocks until you run into those pistons here. Then while we're here, let's actually place two blocks like so and a raised block there. Put a repeater on one tick here and one tick there. And then simply a line of blocks with redstone wire all the way over there, and then cut off the wire there with a full block. Next, let's go and add some more redstone wire on top of this block, those two blocks, then a repeater on three ticks here, a block on top of the repeater followed by an upside down step, redstone wire on top, then another repeater on three ticks, and then finally let's add a few more redstone wire to connect with that line over there. Then grab a steel piston, place it right next to this upside down slab here, put an observer in this direction, next to that an upside down slab here. On top we need a repeater on three ticks running into a full block with a torch to the side of it, block on top, torch to the side of that one, block on top. Then next to this torch here we need another block with a repeater on three ticks in this direction, running into a full block with a torch to the side of it. Then while we're here, let's place a block in this corner here, then a raised block here, followed by another block there. So one layer down here, put some redstone dust there, cut off the wire here with a full block, then put a repeater on one tick there. On top here we need two more blocks with some redstone wire here and a repeater on one tick again in this direction. Then we need a column of three sticky pistons which should be powered by this and this repeater here. Then let's go and add a block here on top of the torch and next to it. Then we go down a layer here, put down two redstone wire like this. Then we need a lower block here with a repeater in this direction on one tick, running into the front of an observer. Then grab your dispensers and place them facing this way, like here. And with that, it's time for another test. So once you power this line at the back here, what should happen is those dispensers clicking, roughly at the same time the sticky pistons here extend and then shortly after retract, and we get another click out of the dispensers. So if you do that, as you can see, that's what we want to see. Also, those pistons here extending is perfect. And if we depower it, only those pistons here should retract and nothing else should happen. Okay, that's looking good so far. Now to keep water in, let's quickly add two normal blocks here, followed by an upside down slab there. Then let's go to the back side here. And from this corner block here, we first go up diagonally with a block with some redstone dust on top. Then a block on top and next to this redstone dust. Another block diagonally up here, redstone dust here, and a repeater on four ticks up there. Now, hovering above this block, we need a normal piston. Then with a two wide gap, another one opposing here, with another normal piston on top. Then place a redstone block right there. Next, we need diagonally to this redstone block here. A normal block with a repeater on 3 ticks. So this would be powered by the redstone block if those pistons here push it over. Run this into a full block with a torch on the side of it. And then diagonally to the torch, we need a sticky piston which should extend right into the space here next to the future water column. This is basically what closes the entire cabin towards the top. Now it's time for the main signal lines. For that we start right behind this top normal piston here. Place a block there, then a block towards the front, and then we need an observer facing downwards. Following that we need a full block, then a node block, then another observer which should line up with this full block and the node block we placed in the very beginning. Then we continue on with an observer block and node block. This should be the full height of 9 blocks for our module. Then on the opposite side, we basically do something very similar, but this time we start again with a node block down here. Put an observer on top, block on top, node block on top, observer on top, block on top, then a node block on top, and finally another observer on top, which should end up into another block. Now while we're here, let's actually add a upside-down step between the two node blocks here, put some redstone dust on top. Then right below it, we need a normal piston facing downwards, followed by two normal blocks, and a composter with at least a single layer of compost in it. Then in between those two node blocks, we need a normal piston facing upwards, which should have a single gap to the composter there. Now for the next two signal lines, we start at the level of this node block over there. And first we go over with a gap of 4 blocks and place our first observer facing upwards. Following that, a normal block, then a node block, then we need a total of 4 observers, followed by a full block, node block. Now we should be at the same height as we stop with the other signal lines. And now we more or less mirror this, so we start with an observer facing downwards, running into a full block, node block, then 4 observers, full block, and a node block. Now let's quickly add a block on top of this. So a piston there. And now we need to connect this line with a bit of the circuitry over there. So first let's go up a layer, then towards the back up a layer and another block here. Put down 3 redstone wires, so we are now running into this block. Put a block down there, take an output with a repeater on 1 tick and run this into a full block. Lower block to the side, redstone wire here, another repeater on 1 tick there. Run this into a full block with a lowered block here, then lowered block to this side and another one there. Place a button here, then we need another lowered block here. Put 3 redstone wire here, a repeater there, running into a full block, and another one tick repeater on top of that block running into this block. The button here, by the way, is just to redirect this wire, so you could also use a lever or similar. And that's the circuitry more or less finished. And that means now you could either start with copying this to all the different modules, which I would actually recommend before we start placing in our waterlogged blocks. And voila, so now I've copied it to all floors, with the exception of the very topmost floor, as mentioned before. This floor is rather simplistic, and well, let's quickly get to it. So the first step we need to do for this floor is to place a single sticky piston towards the back, which would extend this block here into the elevator cabin. Now we need to power it from the next lower module, going from this torch, which essentially connects to the sticky piston, which would connect or close the top of that elevator tube here. And we need to make sure that when this part of the tube is closed, this part at the top is also closed. So in this case, it simply fits that we just need to place our torch up here. If it didn't fit like this, I would just have to place some redstone wire instead. Or you would have possibly have to add a double inversion in there. So block to one side and then just by going diagonally twice, you would have an inversion. But in this case, since the minimum distance is used, this works out quite nicely like this here. Now we need to continue this line down here. So all that's left or missing here is the observer facing downwards and the full block and the observer there. Don't worry about this opening up. This is not really an issue. Now let's go and let's add one node block on top of this observer here. Then when we're there, we can actually remove this node block since it's not needed. Now let's go and add the block on top, redstone dust on top, block on top and to the side. Now add three blocks in total, and now we need three repeaters on two ticks each, which we still need to connect to this redstone line over there. So just run a line of blocks all the way over here. Just make sure that you leave enough space for this piston to extend and you don't block this piston accidentally in some way. And that's the topmost module actually finished. So as you can see, when I press the button here, this should close up. And if I press, for example, this button here, this part here should actually open up. And while we're here, we can already close in the rest of the walls. So this module is completely finished. If you want, you can still add the floor, obviously, and the ceiling. But now it's getting a bit more interesting, because now let's talk about interconnecting the different floors. So the first floor to interconnect is, as you can see, already almost done, since I've built them at the minimum distance. And as you can see, it nicely fits for those four main signal lines. There's still one connection missing, and that is the connection of this redstone torch down here to those two repeaters here. It doesn't matter whether it interacts with this redstone line down there, or it will anyway interact with this redstone line. Anyway, let's continue with a block up here. And if you are at the minimum distance, all you need to do is place a torch up here and a block on top. And what we want to see is that when this piston down here is extended, the two repeaters up here are not powered. If you have the problem that they would be powered if you just had a simple torch tower, you will have to add a inversion in between. What's important is that you have either a full block here or a torch here. What you can't do is place some redstone wire here, or this wire over here, or this signal over here will get into this circuit here, and that's not what we want. Anyway, let's quickly continue on with the few other modules, and after the next cut you will see how I have interconnected those two further away modules. And voila, so now I have those four main signal lines interconnected. And as you can see, it's just a simple repeating pattern of block, observer, node block, with the observer looking at the node block each time. Now, in this case here, I had a nice distance that was a multitude of three, so it fit perfectly in there. If you have a different distance, you will have to either leave out just the normal block at one point, or leave out the normal block and the node block. And now the last part we need to interconnect is actually the torch tower. So again, we start with the torch down here, which powers this single piston up there. And now we make a simple torch tower all the way to the top. And in this case, we have to make be careful that now the torch here would be turned on, since it's not powered from below. Since the torch down here is already on, we need to add another inversion here. As mentioned before, you can simply place some redstone wire here, or you would have some interconnection with this line at the back here, which we don't want. So in this case, simply place another block, for example, towards the back here. And let's add one more inversion before we start with this setup here. And that's the circuitry more or less finished. Now we can give it a test run. So if we press the button for the level 5, for example, what should happen is this part here opening up, those retracting, and here just opening up. If we go one higher, this one here at the top should open up. This one here should be opened up, and those here should extend. If we go to down, for example, what should happen is all of those here should close again, be in this state here. And at the bottom here, now this here should be open and close on the outside, and this here should be completely open. Now, if you haven't already done it, you can start filling in the water tubes or the future water tubes where you have a bigger distance between floors, like here. And while we're here, we can also, which I forgot a bit earlier, start filling in our emergency exit. So for that, we go at the layer where we start with our circuitry, essentially, and place a block next to this node block here. Then we go a layer down, place three blocks, put down three redstone wire, block on top of this last one, and then a button here, which should be accessible from this gap in there. And that should be connected or repeated on all floors, with the exception of the bottommost floor, since there is nothing below, obviously. And once you have done that, I will finally get to actually filling in the waterlogged blocks right there. But before that, one quick correction. Those three blocks here actually need to be one layer behind the walls, so they need to be placed like this here. And once you are at this layer, it's time to start filling in a few more blocks. First, let's start with a block next to this piston here. This is later on to keep water from spilling out. Then let's look in here from the top and let's place three stairs like this here. Then, on top of that, we need one stair in this direction. Here, we have again three stairs with the blank face towards the outside. Then, let's add one stairs block here. Another stairs block, like this here, and then another one in this direction. So now you should have two stairs blocks that look like this. Then let's go and add one block here, and one block there. Now we're getting to the dangerous part, and that is waterlogging this block and this block, and this block. Before you waterlock, obviously make sure that there are no gaps where the water can spill out. That's why the form or the shape of those two stairs here is rather important. Then let's waterlock this block and this block. And now let's go to those three dispensers here, and let's place a single bucket in each of them. Then put three stairs against this side. They should now be in a corner configuration, since we have those stairs connecting to them. And the same should be true if you place three stairs here. And now also waterlock those three stairs here. And once more, before you waterlock, you might want to make sure that there is no possibility of water getting spilled out, or you will most likely have to replace quite a bit of redstone circuitry below it. And that's basically the waterlocking for the module itself. Obviously, you also need to waterlock the entire water tube in between the modules. And voila, so now everything is finished up. The topmost module obviously only needs the waterlock blocks at the bottom. And once you have waterlocked everything, it's time to give it a test run. So for example, let's try to go from the topmost to the bottommost floor. And what you want to see is that those floors here will, after a short amount of time, completely close up, except for the ultimate floor where we want to go. And if we go in the opposite direction, it should pretty much happen in the same way. Just that now we, instead of a magma block, we have a soul sand block down there. And that's looking good so far. Which means now it's time to start filling in the different floors and also the ceilings. And voila, so now as I can see, the elevator is finished up, which also means that we have reached the end of this tutorial about how you can build this retractable corner water elevator with a direct and exclusive level selection. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!